This lecture will cover the basics of moving coil galvanometer. Before we proceed, let us just understand the concept which is involved. Let this be a coil and let the cross section area of the coil be A. This is the perpendicular, this is the surface vector means perpendicular to the plane of the coil. We know that torque on a coil which carries current I is equal to N is the number of turns, I is the current, A is the cross section area cross B, means it is equal to N I A B sine theta. Please note that this angle theta is not the angle between the plane of the coil and the magnetic field. No, it is the angle between the normal to the coil and the magnetic field, because area vector is always taken as perpendicular to the cross section area. So you have to see angle between the perpendicular to the area and the magnetic field, not the plane. So that was just the basic. Now what is done in case of moving coil galvanometer is that design is made in such a way that this theta is always 90, and this is done when you have a core. Let this be the core on which it is the top view, and let this be the coil. If I take the side view from here, you will see the coil like this. This is the coil. This is the side view. Now, if you make magnet in this shape, they are curved in the same curvature as the curvature of this core. So whatever will be the position of this plane, this can rotate on this axis. It can rotate. This is a core. Let me draw it again. On this core, you have the coil, and this core is arranged in such a way there is a strip at the top, and this is stretched at the bottom. It is just like a hanging kind of cylinder, but this strip has tendency to restore the rotation back. Suppose you rotate this cylinder, this strip will take it back because of the torsional constant. Now there is a coil on it, and we supply the current to it. Current is supplied, some voltage is supplied. So when the current flows through the coil, it experiences torque in presence of magnetic field. If this is the north pole and this is the south pole, the magnetic field is going like this at all the places. So when we look at the coil, just see how the magnetic field and the area of the coil. This is the area vector and this is the magnetic field. So area vector is always perpendicular to the magnetic field. If the coil has rotated and come to this position, this is the new position of the coil. The area vector will be like this. This is the new area vector. And see, the magnetic field is again going perpendicular to the area vector. So in this arrangement, the torque is always equal to N I A B. N is number of turns, I is current, A is the cross section area, means this area of the coil, and B is the magnetic field. Now when the current is passed through this coil, it experiences this torque, because of which it tries to rotate. when this tries to rotate, this strip will twist and this will have an impact. Torque on this strip will be equal to k times theta, where theta is the angle turned by this, rotated by the strip, and k is the constant which has tendency to bring it back. So we write k theta is equal to NIAB, and by this relationship we can find the value of current as NAB. We can measure angle theta by various means. We can place a mirror, reflecting mirror, which gives the reflection on certain scale. There is a source of light and you can measure on that. You can also have a needle kind of arrangement moving along this scale to measure angle theta. So this is the basic principle on which the moving coil galvanometer works. Thank you.